Hello, my brothers and sisters. Jesus bless you. Jesus bless you. I hope King Jesus is filling your cup full of just joy and peace and fruits of the Spirit. Amen. Listen, I know that there's a lot going on out here, and we're all cooped up and we're all stuck inside. But some of us are still out here and some of us aren't. And that's okay, because God is sovereign and He's in control and He knows where everybody needs to be, right? When you acknowledge the Lord in all thy ways, He shall direct your path. Amen. And so He's got some of us out here, and then He's got some of us at home just staying and pushing into the Lord and reading scripture and intercessing. And listen, your prayers are powerful. So, you know, when you feel like you're not doing enough for the Lord, rebuke that, you know, because you're very valuable to Jesus and He loves you very much. And I know some of you are getting really down on yourself because you feel like you're not doing enough for the Lord and you're stuck inside, why some of us are still out here. But let me tell you something, we're many members, but one body. Amen. So, we all come together in unity, and sometimes Jesus needs us to go, some to go out here. He places out there, and He places some to come in and intercess, because prayer is powerful. Amen. And speaking of all this is what I wanted to get my video into, just to encourage you all about childlike giving. Amen. Childlike giving. And there's some scriptures I'm going to read to you too that I'm going to explain. And so I'm just going to give you a testimony of at work. Jesus healed a little girl that I prayed for, and I was in the break room, and there was a gentleman in there, and I could tell he was a little stressed out, so I, you know, struck up a conversation with him, and just showed my love for him, because that's what Jesus wants to do, guys. He wants to show His love through us to others. Amen. And so if we can just see the people the way Jesus sees the people and love them first, that's all that matters. And so from love, I came up and we started discussing things, and he was telling me his little girl was sick. His little girl is 5, but she just turned 6. So he was telling me how she was sick, and so I felt really led to pray, and I prayed for his little girl, and about a day and a half later, I mean, she was really sick, he said, and he was really bummed out about this, and she was really, really sick. And so we prayed right there in the break room at work. And when I saw him again, not the next time I saw him, but the next time I saw him, which was like a day later, 24 hours, 36 hours later, his little girl who was really sick got healed. And he was so excited. And he was almost in tears when we talked again, telling me how his little girl was better, and that he couldn't believe that somebody would actually care enough to say something to him, to encourage him, to pray for him and his family. Amen. And that's all it takes, guys. I mean, if we go in with just the love of Jesus, and we have no agenda but to love others, ask the Lord to show you how He loves others. Ask Him to put that in you. And if that is your motive, fear of man will go away. Amen. And so King Jesus is just amazing, and it's just about relationship. It's just about pleasing Him, and it's about being about His business, and His business is souls. And you know, we know the Lord loves. So if you can just love the people first, there's no other agenda, and that fear of man will fall off. Amen. So I just wanted to share this testimony with you, how excited he was. And he got like crying, and he said to me, you know, I can't believe you did this. Like, I can't believe you cared. And I told him that I had the love for him and his family. I love you with the same love that's Christ is in me. Amen. Christ Jesus. And I told him it was all Jesus. You know, we give all glory to God. Amen. And he just, you know, was taken back about that. So what am I trying to say, guys? Childlike giving is when you are selfless and you pour yourself out like Jesus did and expect nothing in return. Not even a pat on the back, nothing. But just coming from your heart of just sheer love. Amen. Just sheer love. Fear of man goes away, and it's so fulfilling, and it's beautiful. And you'll be able to do these things for Jesus. You're an ambassador for Christ. Amen. And so I just wanted to share with you like a few days later, maybe possibly almost a week later, he comes in and he says, I have a gift for you. And I said, okay, what's that? And his little girl made me these bracelets, okay? And in these bracelets, one says blessed and one says Jesus, amen? And it was just pretty amazing how it just really touched my heart. And God had reminded me of this story in Luke and in Mark, I believe, Luke 21 and Mark 12. And it was about the widow. And we can go in, and I'm going to read this scripture to you here. The widow's mite. This is going to be Mark chapter 12, verse 41. And he sat down opposite the treasury and began observing how the people were putting money into the treasury. And many rich people were putting in large sums. A poor widow came and put in two small copper coins, which amounted to a cent. Calling his disciples to him, he said to them, truly I say to you, this poor widow put in more than all the contributors to this treasury. For they all put in all their surplus, but she, out of her poverty, put in all she owned, and she had to live on. So what am I trying to say, guys? What I'm trying to say is we can give in childlike faith, okay? We can empty ourselves out and just love on people out there that need to see and feel the love of Christ, you know, in this lost and dying world out here, amen? And you don't have to have a lot of money. What God is looking for is your heart. What is your motive? What is your heart? Why are you doing this? This widow had nothing. She was poor as can be. But you know what Jesus saw? Her heart. Her heart. She gave literally nothing, everything out of nothing, because she gave her whole heart. Amen. And so that's what I want to share with you. When this little girl who's 6 years old, she don't have money, she don't have nothing, but she made this for me because she was excited. She made this for me out of love. And so I just wanted to share this with you because we can learn something in this, guys. A lot of people don't have jobs right now. I know you guys are down in the dumps. You're saying you don't have no money. It's not about going out there and having a bunch of money and helping people, okay? You can take what Jesus has given you and we'll say in a sense your poverty. Okay, your poverty, not saying you're poor. It's just when you don't have much to work with right now, but you give it your all. Okay. So what did the widow do? She had nothing, but she gave everything from her heart. Amen. Isn't that beautiful? And so when I realized what this little girl did, she had nothing, guys. She don't soil or toil. She don't reap or sow. She's 5 years old, and she gave everything that she had from her heart. Amen. Amen. And so this is what Jesus is showing us in Luke 21 and Mark 12. Okay. Sit back and assess, what did God give you today, guys? Okay. Do you have a cell phone? Great. Great. Use that cell phone to call up family members, call up people, call up neighbors, and pray for them. Amen. Do you have a mouth? Yeah, you can speak encouraging words over your neighbors, people out in the store, your family. Amen. If you have a car and you know someone in your family don't, or your neighbors need help, offer your car. Offer, be like an Uber driver for them. It's offer your time, offer your love, your uninvited attention. Amen. And so what we learn in this is you don't have to have anything at all to give everything. Amen. And that's what Jesus is searching for, guys. And here's another example. It was so beautiful. It touched my heart. And now he says, you know, that his wife and his little girl talk about me more as if they know me. And he said, gee, you don't even know her. I know her. And you guys talk about her more. He says, the little girl talks about me all the time. His little girl, his wife. And it's just been amazing. And that's just it, guys. You can make an impact in people's lives if you allow God to use you. If you allow to be a vessel for God. Okay, a little bit can go a long way. Just some kind words, a smile. Do you have pen and paper? You can write scripture down or a nice note and put it in your neighbor's mailbox. Anything that shows a step of love. So you can have nothing and give everything. Amen. So that's our word. Out of nothing, you can give everything when it's 100% your heart. Hallelujah. And so I just wanted to show you another example. You know, I preach in the jails, and anybody who's been in jail knows that you don't have nothing there. Inmates don't have anything there. And you know what they did? They ripped off, guys, pieces of their shirt and made me a bookmark, okay, for my Bible. Made me a bookmark. And you know what? They had nothing. And so out of nothing, guys, out of nothing, they gave everything. You want to know why? Because it was from their heart. Amen. We don't need a lot of money, guys. We don't need a lot of resources. All we need is to be a willing vessel for Jesus. All we need is just us. All we need is just love. All we need to do is ask the Lord Jesus to help us love others. Amen. And he will do that. He is faithful. Amen. And you'll be able to impact people's lives. And even if you don't see the fruit in front of your face, it doesn't matter. Like, anything we do for the Lord is not void. Amen. And so you don't know what kind of fruit that will come. You don't know what kind of atmosphere that'll change right in their house. When that gentleman went home to his family and did this, it changed their whole atmosphere. Amen. And so I shared this for making this video. So this is another gift that this little girl gave me. She wrote MJ. Amen. Let's see what's in it, guys. Let's see what's in this. Oh, she made me another little bracelet. How beautiful is that, guys? And I got a little, a cross trinket. Wow. And let's see what this says. She made me a magnet. MJ, Ray Lynn. Oh my goodness, with hearts. Look, my name, MJ, with hearts. Amen. And so see, it's not about the gift. It's about that I impacted somebody's life because I allowed Jesus to use me as a vessel. I allow Jesus to come alive inside me and exude out to them. Amen. So I just wanted to encourage you guys, while you're locked up and you're bound up and you feel like you can't do anything, can't go nowhere, can't do anything, for the Lord, cheer up, take heart. For God has overcome the world, and out of nothing, you can give everything. Amen. And so I just wanted to share that with you. It's just so beautiful how the Lord works, and you are valuable. You are loved, and God wants to use you, and you will impact people's lives if you just yield to the Spirit. Amen. And so I just wanted to share this with you all, what it means from what God is looking for when he says childlike giving. Amen. All right, Jesus bless you all. Until next time, I hope Jesus fills your cup full of peace and joy and fruits of the Spirit. I love you all. You need anything, you need prayers, lift it down into the comments. And listen, give prayer. There's so many ways, okay, that you can give to others. Okay, and be selfless like Jesus Christ is. Amen. All right, I love you all. Jesus bless you all.